Hey guys, and welcome back to the island. Ladies and gentlemen, last episode we worked on a cacti farm. Thank you so much for the likes on that video. You guys seem to like the idea of my cactiing. And look at this. Boom. We've got quite a bit of cacti. I'm actually gonna... Yeah, I'll bring everything. Okay, so this is our item sorting system endpoint at the moment. Remember, we've only hooked it up to the deep storage units, and that means that I've hooked up our That means that I've hooked up the cacti farm to the item sorting system, and I'm actually pretty proud of it. I'll show you in a minute. First, let me go and put one stack over there. One stack over there. You may wonder, why on earth do I want so much cacti? Well, because it's cool. Nope, but because it makes green. And from green we can get lime, which is something we're gonna need. I'm also gonna take, there we go. Okay, so we let some of that smelt up. We're gonna use it here in a minute. Anyway, I'll show you the transportation system that I made. I hope that you're doing fantastic today. I hope that you're doing well. I'm doing pretty good myself, getting pretty excited about Minecraft 1.9. Look at that beast, looking terribly ugly, but we're gonna fix it. So this is what we got. Yeah, I'm getting pretty excited about Minecraft 1.9. Can I make this though? Oh man, I am a pro. Okay, just got a cacti there. There's been some rumors that I've heard that we'll get colored latches, colored hatch doors, trap doors, whatever they are called in vanilla, and I really like that. And colored signs and ladders, hopefully, as well. That's why I'm excited. Color can do so much to your mind. Look at this beautiful place, though. This thing is super ugly, but that's what we're gonna use the green for. Okay, so anyway, this isn't finished. We need to build it a little bit taller, I think, but it's pretty efficient, like the sheer or the amount. The loot that you saw is probably from 2 hours, maybe 3 hours of AFKing, so it's pretty efficient actually. But I think I want to make it a little bit taller. Anyway, so we started this, but we didn't have time in the last episode, so I finished it. Cacti fall down here, they travel into this water stream, and then down there into another water stream, and terrible. There we go. From there, they go underneath here, I believe it is. Do I have... Crap. I'm gonna lose that piece of dirt. Yep, there it goes. So they travel here, and if I throw something in here, let's throw the mushroom stew and possibly 3 pieces of wheat. This thing is connected up to here, where it drops down, and we'll take a look. I'm just... can't really fix this now, can I? Nope. Oh wait, I have an idea. I know how to fix. You think I'm not a fixer? You think I'm brand new? I ain't brand new. Check me out. Boom. There we go. Put that on top. Okay, so they travel and then they go down here. Boop. Into another water stream. And again, the water is floating on ice, which makes the items flow very quick. Goes all the way over here. And then skips all the way into this hopper, which is basically our input system, the input chest that we already had. So from there, it goes into the item sorter. Now, for those of you who are my modded fans, or modded viewers, you can look at this water stream as our kind of main item duct input thing. Because what we'll do is we'll use the same item stream or possibly make another one as well. So we'll have 2 main item lines for other farms, and then we'll just throw everything in there. And the things that we threw in, the mushroom stew and that, should have made it all the way, possibly, hopefully, if I can get up here, to the end chest. Yeah, look at that. 3 wheat and 1 mushroom stew, which I'm gonna eat. Okay, fantastic. I also did another thing over here, and this is actually a while ago, but now since we're here, may just as well show you this. This is what we're looking at is this piece right here, the lava, the redstone. It's very dirty at the moment, but it's basically a concept. So remember how I said we're gonna need an overflow protection system. So this is the deep storage unit for smooth stone, which you can see we've already filled like 5 double chest worth of chests. And what I built here is basically a system that will burn any excess stone once this chest, let me see, yeah, once this chest fills up, and once this hopper fills up, and this hopper fills up, what's going to happen is this comparator is going to turn on, the redstone signal is going to travel down and around and under, and then it's going to start a pulsating clock which powers this dropper right here. It's also going to power this repeater, which locks this hopper here, or sorry, unlocks this hopper here, meaning that items will travel to this chest, and if they're already in the chest and this unlocks, they will travel into the lava. I wonder if I am quick enough to demonstrate this. I guess if I break this, now this is unfrozen, and you'd have to imagine that this hopper is already full, so nothing can go in there. And if I do this, yeah, as you can see, they travel into this hopper, into that, and into the dropper, and for some reason, oh yeah, because this redstone signal ain't active, see? This would have been active, let me just demonstrate or illustrate. That happens, this cobblestone will get burned. Yep, or sorry, the stone will get burned, so any excess will get burned. And I remember a time in my last vanilla world where I built a trash can and people started flaming and hating. They were like, how on earth can you throw things away in a survival vanilla world? You're crazy. Well, come on now. If you have excess stone, there is no point in like building tons and tons of room for that stone because it ain't gonna help you anyway. Okay, so that's a little bit of stuff that I've been up to. This is the last of our clay. That's crappy. Because I'm going to need that right now. What we're going to do is start trying to decorate the cacti farm. Oh, look at this. All the cacti die in the world. And that room is loud. So the reason I had a boundary around the cacti farm, I'm also going to need a little bit of bone meal. Boop. And let's do this. Let's throw those out. Sorry if I'm throwing things away. Let's get a little bit of black. Okay. The reason I have the boundaries around the I'm completely disoriented here today, and I'm disorienting you guys. I'm sorry for that. But the reason we have a boundary, a box around the cacti farm at the moment, this thing here, is because the cacti would pop and flow out to the side and bad things will happen because they will have nowhere to go. So we're gonna fix that. That's why I put up this temporary thing, just to see the efficiency of the thing. But my idea is that we build, and we're gonna use a lot of lime for this, but I think dye is gonna be the least of our problem. Let's try and build a cacti looking thing. Now, there are two different cacti's in my head. And I've done this before. Jeez, this would have been quicker if I just put everything in there. I think that's fine, yeah. And then we'll make a few green ones as well. Maybe green is going to be our accent and lime is going to be our main color. We're also going to use black. We may actually have enough stuff here. Do I have a chest? Yes, I do. This is my woodcutting chest right here. There are two types of cacti. You have your Minecraft cacti that looks like this, which we could pretty easily pixel art make a mimic of. It goes something like that, and then we'd have black stained clay coming out like that every now and then, and it could look pretty cool. I've done that before, and more importantly, one of the first times I was completely stuck with Let's Play videos on YouTube, and by completely stuck I mean had to go back and watch every episode, was when I saw Seth Bling a few years ago post a video for a cacti farm on the Minecraft server, and the little thumbnail thing was a picture of a gigantic cacti, and I thought it looked fantastic. And he basically did that, and then I did that on a server I was playing on, and it was all good and fun. But for this thing, I wanted to try and make a cacti that looks like this, and this is just a miniature thing. But you know the Western cacti? Is it correct to say Western cacti? I don't know. They kind of look like this. You know? Oh, that's actually pretty cool looking. Just having like that. In a desert? But we're going to build a gigantic one. So I think I want to do that design instead of the squarey, even though this is going to probably look, or that's easier to do. I think I want to try my luck at doing one of those. So basically this would be the middle stem. I'm not sure if we actually should consider making this farm a little bit smaller. Like it's too fat at the moment. I'm worried it's going to be too fat. I'm worried it's going to be too big, but we'll see what happens. But that's what I'm going to try to do. So change this out. And then I'm going to go with the lime as the base color. Look at how pretty this clay is. Come on now, ladies and gentlemen. That is a gorgeous block color. That's probably the best clay there is. That and yellow. People seem to hate yellow, though. But I think it's pretty. Can't hate yellow. That's silly. But yeah, we'll have this as our kind of base color, I think. And then we'll come over now and then and we'll have like darker spots just to give it a little bit of texture. Because if there's one thing that clay doesn't have is texture, shadows, or whatever you want to call it. And then we'll possibly also add some of those black spots that I was talking about just to make it pointy. Yeah, I think it's going to look pretty cool. Let me give myself a try and see what we can come up with here. All right, so I got two sides replaced, and let's be honest with each other, it's going to be too fat if we choose to go with this design, I think. Because you have to consider the things coming out from the sides. So I think... Ouch! So I think what I'll do is I will make this a little bit less efficient, but prettier looking. So what we could do is that. Yeah, so... Wow, I lagged there. Okay, so if we take away... We make it three... So this is 4x4. Let's make it 3x3 instead. Is that going to affect anything? If I take away... We have to be smart about this so I don't have to redo the item stream. No, I think what we'll do is we'll shave this here. Right? And then we'll shave off the front side that I started with. And that should make it... so that we don't have to redo anything with the item stream. We just have to cut it short there. And I think this is worth it. And this is like, if I don't do this now, I may forever be very upset about that I never did it. So it's better just to do it now. And you know what? The string we're going to need, because I'm actually out of string. That's why I can't make it taller at the moment. So hopefully I didn't mess up too bad with most of these. Okay, so making it a little bit shorter. And if you didn't understand, by the way, should say, I always get these ideas in my head that I'm not explaining things properly, but then, you know, you're probably smart guys, so you probably figured it out. But the chest that it's currently landing in, the item collection system, is essentially, of course, going to auto-sort everything we put into it, right? So the cacti will end up in the cacti chest, etc., etc., etc. Okay, anyway, putting the cacti farm on a diet is what I'm doing. That's silly. Oh, an uninvited guest, huh? You ain't a pirate, you stupid idiot. Okay, so I shaved off, made it, put it on a diet, and I think it's much better now. It's definitely better. Thinking about doing this as well. Making it a little bit round could be good. Oh, and I dig in the one corner where my haste doesn't reach. Fantastic. Okay. so shaving off the corners, making it crap. Making it crap. How are we gonna solve that though? That's a little bit of an issue right there, actually. Okay. For now, let's do that. Okay? No one says anything. That could be an issue. But yeah, making round corners. I should have done this side, is what I should have done. So that we can see what's going on. I think that's gonna be better, actually. Height-wise, I think it needs to go bigger. And I hope that you guys are agreeing with me. So, or taller I should say, which was also the original plan. I did bring a little bit more sand and cacti and string. So basically, while we bring up the height for the sake of it looking better, it's also increasing the efficiency of the farm. Oh, I think I just painted myself in here. Yes, I got it. Okay, so do that and it's dangerous in here, okay? Do that. And how is the next one now coming? So, okay, so we're doing each other here. Yeah. So we'd have boop, 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 sand. And I wonder how much taller we should make it. But possibly two more of these layers could be good. We need some height on it anyway. All right. That is two more layers up. And I think, hopefully, this height is good. Now, what's important that I actually didn't discuss, of course, in the last... Or, of course, but what I didn't discuss in the last episode... Oh, that's going to be bad, actually. Hold on. We need to be clever around this. So, we want to have... Yeah, we want to have a layer... One more layer here. So that the top cacti will also get harvested. Every time they grow. And then we'll put... We'll cap the cacti on top here, and that's what I was gonna say is gonna be important, because otherwise you'll have your top cacti just grow to 3 tall and never be harvested, which wouldn't be good. I guess I did that wrong, but it doesn't really matter. So there we go. Yeah, everyone got a block next to it, and that's what's important. So I guess we have to bring this up like so, and that may actually be too tall. We'll see how it looks though. Oh, that's a throw if I ever saw one. Okay. good things that I was recording. Now, is this height good enough? I capped it off at the top. I did the corners. I think that's pretty cool. It's huge. That is what I heard that she's supposed to say. It's huge. It's big. It's large. But I think it's going to be pretty cool, actually. I do think so. Now, unfortunately, we're out of clay, which sucks. So we aren't going to be able to finish this today. I did too much. I should have made everything lime from the beginning. But let's just try and mark out, I suppose. Suppose these could come out here and then we'll leave maybe 3 blocks spacing. No, that's going to be too big. Maybe just 2 block spacing. let's just see how that looks. And don't you worry, they aren't going to be 1 pixel wide. I just want to see the bottom of it. So then what would happen then is that it would come out maybe 4. Let's go up here. Let's just see how this looks. Gotta make things look beautiful. That's the most important thing ever. Which is actually a comment that I got early on in this series where I said, you know, I ain't gonna focus so much on building, but I wanna focus a little bit. And someone said, do whatever you want, man. If you wanna focus on building, do it, because Minecraft is so much about building. And it is, it's true. You want things to look pretty and gorgeous. I think that's a pretty good width for it. We'll have another one over there. It looks a little bit like a moose at the moment. We'll have another bit over there, but I'm gonna have to collect some clay before I can do that, and I really don't feel like doing that right now. But yeah, I think this is gonna look good. We're gonna have those there and another one there. The item stream and everything is still working. We're obviously gonna come with some shaders, as I said earlier, so we'll have some dark color like this. Possibly. There we go. Maybe something like that on the corner. We could also wrap it around. Make it look a little bit better. Maybe one more up. Oops. Like that. Yeah. I think that's gonna look good. I think it's gonna look fantastic in the end. I hope that you guys are liking it. It's a little bit weird. It's a little bit pixel design art thing, which is something that we haven't done here before. But on the other hand, it's fun to have things sticking up off the ground in your base as well, I think. I think that's important. Alright, we'll leave the cacti farming for today. I want to get started on a huge part of our world that I'm looking very much forward to building and that we're going to have a big use of. So we've done the mine. This is kind of like the mine. It's going to be an ongoing project, but I have some pretty cool idea. Let me bring some andesite. I almost forgot that. I'm over here because we need to retire another pickaxe. The Ripper 1 is done for. Remember that I also broke Worker 2 when we worked on the ink farm, so we need to make like a stone pickaxe variation of it, I suppose. I don't know. But anyway, what we're going to start working on, or at least start talking about, is the Nether. So let me head to the Nether, and I'll bring you in on a little bit of an idea that I think will be super fun to work on, and that I'm going to enjoy anyway. So I see you in the Nether. Such a beautiful place it is, huh? It's actually pretty bad. I don't really like the Nether in vanilla Minecraft. I think it's too plain and boring. But okay, so very quickly in our world here, I'm starting to get a lot of portals to different places. The clay, for example, if I wanted to go mine some clay, at the moment, I think it's this way, 4,000 overworld blocks, or something like 500 blocks. Is that correct? Split by 8? Yeah, something like that. In the Nether. And it's very disoriented. I think it's the same for the jungle. If I want to go to the ink farm, it's over there. I actually made a teleporter or a portal for that. The end is over there. All in all, it's looking pretty terrible. And I wanted to start working on our Nether. And so I have a few ideas for design that I want to go with. Usually when I do Nether hubs or Nether builds, I try to make the Nether look like the overworld. But I think what I want to do you notice how there is like a red tint in the Nether? There's like a very small red tint, and then there's stupid gas sounding, of course, or making noise, but there is like a red tint over it. It's not just the netherrack, it's actually pretty reddish. There he is, stupid idiot. Can I get you? No, not a chance. Wait, maybe. Ah, oh, crap. Okay. And I want to make use of building wise. Whew, that was dangerous. I want to make use of building wise. The red tint. And so my plan is that we create a Hellforge thing, if that's a word, like a smithing area with a lot of lava in the design, dark, hellish, a Hellforge. I think it's going to be gorgeous. I brought a little bit of stuff so that we could put up a workshop over here. Like I said, this is something that we're going to have to be working on for a bit, but I wanted to share with you a little bit of a block. Let me just do this. I can't stand the portals. I said that in the last episode. Can't stand the sound. That's a thing that we're going to need to do. Turn them on and off. What was I going to say? Yeah, I brought a little bit of stuff. I wanted to kind of set a block chart, or at least get a little bit of an idea of what I want to do up here today. I'm going to need to go fetch some lava, though, before I do, because I do want to incorporate lava in this build. But what we could do... the first thing I'm going to have to do, though, is to change up where this portal is, because I don't want it sitting randomly in the on the pirate island. I want to have, like, an area for it, and so I have to relink it and make sure that it's correctly linked. Because with this Hellforge, there are going to be two major things, okay? or three major things. Yeah, three major things. One, it has to look good. It has to be beautiful and gorgeous. Second, it has to be functional in the way of transporting us from different areas in the world of Minecraft to other different areas in the world of Minecraft. And third of all, it has to have a technicality to it that allows me to transfer mobs or items or stuff from the area. So not only should it be for my transportation, but maybe if we have the ink farm over there, just as an example, I want to have a way of transferring the ink back. So the Hellforge, which is totally the name of the place, is going to require a sort of a storage facility, like a middle land tier storage facility. I don't know what I'm saying. I don't know if that's even a word. And there are a few challenges to this build as well. And that is that I don't want... I want to avoid as much mob spawning as possible, which in the Nether is almost not achievable unless you spam torches everywhere because of the fact that ghasts and pigmen has a different lighting level spawn ratio than regular mobs. The easiest way to get rid of spawning is using half slabs on your ground. Mobs cannot spawn on half slabs, and so I think that's what we're gonna do for the Hellforge. Now, I'm placing down a little bit of blocks. I haven't really tested this. I want to try and incorporate nether brick is one thing. This nether brick, not this, not that. That's netherrack, this is nether brick. I want to try and incorporate this because I think, first of all, it looks very hellish. And secondly, I think it's fun to build with a block that I've never really used. I've never actually built anything with this, so I want to try and make it work. I don't really love it. I think it's pretty ugly. But that's probably just because I can't do pretty things with it. Now, for the floor, I wanted to kind of have cobblestone. I'm so sorry that we're sad that we can't have cracked stone bricks, because I'm pretty sure we can't, right? As slabs, which is weird. Because that's a thing that works very well with cobblestone, but I don't think... Nah, that just turns it into regular stone bricks. Okay. Obviously, we'll mix it in. We'll make it look broken and hellish and nightmarish. But I think I want to use cobble for the ground, mostly. Somehow, we need to mix in andesite. I also brought some red sand. That's another thing that doesn't exist in half slab form. But what you could do is turn this into the red sand blocks. Although I don't think these are as pretty as the sand. I'm missing the sand texture there. But yeah, hopefully you get a little bit of an idea of the style I want to go with. We're also going to use iron bars, for sure. I think that could look pretty cool together with this. Don't like that it doesn't connect there, though. Just trying out a little bit of a wall design here. That looks pretty cool already. Kind of like, you know, it's a lot like the cave upstairs, actually, where I've also got this hellish, or not hellish, but I got the forge feel with fires and stuff. I want to incorporate that as much as I can. What else do we have? Coarse dirt. What do you know? We're going to do exactly what we do upstairs. No, we aren't, but coarse dirt is a beautiful, gorgeous block, specifically for together with the cobblestone, so we may use that, I'm not sure. The good thing with nether brick is that it's a very flexible block. It has defense gates or fences. It has the stairs and slabs and all that. So that's good. Blackstained clay, possibly. I also brought some ferni. And what I was thinking with these, kind of like you can use them as a floor, although it's not slabbage, but you can use them, like the texture on top of them are pretty cool, I think. Maybe we'll have to skip the whole slabbage idea. We're pretty limited if we go with it. Although it would be kind of fun to see if we can make it as much as possible. I know that there are going to be spots that we can't slab, because it would look too bad. But anyway, let me get the portal moved, and let me come up with some ideas here. And basically what I want to get done today is just a little bit of a seed, if you will, in your heads. Planting a seed in your heads. About how I'm thinking this should look, and then if you guys want to be so kind and let me know what you think, I'll get super motivated. Oops. I'll possibly get super motivated if you guys like it, and then I can do a lot of this stuff off camera. But yeah, that's the basic idea anyway. I hate Ghast so much. Can I make this? This is dangerous. Okay, kids, don't try this at home. I'm a trained professional. Did I make it? Whew, I made it. All right, let me work a little bit and I come back to you. All right, folks, I think I've got a pretty good idea now of what I want to do. Spent some hours here just back and forth, but I think this is looking pretty good. And I wanted to leave you with this before we end this episode. It's probably getting out of hands again, but someone said in the last episode that if you saw an Iskall episode that was an hour long, you would be happy and dancing and cheering. I don't think so, but yeah. Anyway, check this out. So punch you out, put that there, and then lava there. This is kind of, I'm trying to make these represent like Hellforges where lava is pouring down and then the smiths are using them, but this Hellforge has been remade, so it's no longer a forgery, I suppose. It's more like a, I don't know, it looks cool, it looks fantastic, and so we're gonna keep it. Basically what I've been doing, or what I've decided to go with here, is what I would call a makeup build. A makeup build for me is when I have a background block, in this case nether brick, and then I'm putting a facade in front of it, that being the makeup. And it's going to be pretty heavy on the bricks, actually, and I wanted to mix in a little bit of patches like that. Maybe doesn't look too bad. So that's a makeup build for me, and so this is what I call a makeup build. And we have to go over the bricks once it's done and kind of mix in, like I did here, a little bit of andesite and a little bit of crackstone bricks. We have a pretty interesting area over here. Oh, I just got a text message. Quiet phone. I'm recording. Sorry for that. We got quite an interesting area here, which is the upper half of a block, where if we put andesite, I did it over here, I think it looks very good between the two bricks. One thing that we could do that I was thinking about that we could try is for the netherrack, in order to mix it up, or nether brick crap, maybe we could mix in some of that. Well, that's not too good of a mix. Nah. But since this is a flexible block, what we also could do is possibly just do something like this. In places. Like a repair. Yeah. Anyway, I'm very excited about this. I'm probably going to be working on this a little bit more in between episodes. But I hope that you like the style. The next idea is that I'm gonna design rooms, square rooms, with tunnels in between them. So it's not going to be a big circle like usual nether hubs are, but we're going to have different rooms for different areas. That's the nether portal back, by the way. I think it looks pretty good. And on the back here, we'll install some technical stuff later so that we can transport items back and forth using the nether. Because as I said, it's going to be a lot of technical stuff. While I was doing this off camera, my friend called me, one of my best in real life friends called me on my mobile and said, we got to discuss greed. this is a very intelligent friend that I love to death. And as I said, he's one of my best friends, and I love discussing things with him. So that's what I'm going to be doing now. But anyway, the time of the video is up anyway. So I hope that you have enjoyed this episode. And if you have, be sure to hit the like button down below. The Hellforge has started, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for watching, and I see you in the next episode.